Hare Krishna. So today is very, very auspicious day, the divine disappearance day of Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur. So Haridas Thakur is an eternal associate of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So wherever Mahaprabhu goes to perform his pastimes, Haridas Thakur also goes there. Why? Because Mahaprabhu always establishes Haridas Thakur as a Namacharya. So it is said that three personalities are together in Haridas Thakur. Brahma, Lord Brahma, Prahlad Maharaj, and the eternal associate of Lord Chaitanya. So when Haridas Thakur disappeared, so Brahma went back to Satyaloka, Prahlad Maharaj went back to his Sutaloka, and Haridas Thakur went to his eternal abode. So it's not an ordinary personality. So Haridas Thakur is a very special person, and he appeared 35 years before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance. So Haridas Thakur is 35 years elder than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He appeared in 1451. And Mahaprabhu appeared in 1486. So why Haridas Thakur appeared so early? Because in order to be a Namacharya, you have to be elderly. Otherwise people will not accept socially. That's why Mahaprabhu wanted to establish him as a Namacharya, and Mahaprabhu will stay only for 48 years. Everything is predecided. So therefore, Haridas Thakur had to come very early, 35 years before. And why he was not born in a Brahmana family, Vaishnava family? He appeared in a non-Hindu family, a Mlecha family. Why? There are many reasons for that. So Brahma, the position of Brahma is very high position. And when someone is a high position, there is always a possibility of making mistakes, because that is the nature of that position. So Brahma every day is making mistake. Krishna comes every day of Brahma, no? It's not that first time he is seeing Krishna, he is eating with the cowherd boys from the mouth of his friends. Brahma is seeing every day. And he is bewildered. Muhyanti jasuraya. So he started thinking, after he is bewildered, he became very, what do you can say, sinful, that what I am doing. So that is the pastime of Krishna with Brahma. Then Brahma thought that I don't want to make mistake. So he went to Navadvip Dham. And he started worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Antardip. Why it is Antardip? Because Brahma revealed his antar, or heart, to Lord. That's why it is known as Antardip. So he was doing bhajan, he was doing tapasya, worshipping Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because he knew then Kali Yuga, he'll come, again he'll make mistake. So he was worshipping him. Then Mahaprabhu appeared. So Mahaprabhu said, what do you want from me? So Brahma said that I am making mistake. I am not able to understand you. So again you will come in Kali Yuga, so I don't want to make the same mistake. Sincerely. And why I am making this mistake? Because I am having very high position. The topmost position in this world, Brahma. So that's why in your pastime I don't want to take high position. So give me a very low birth so that I will be humble. So Mahaprabhu said, yes, you should take birth in a very low family and that will keep you humble. And you will chant every day 300,000 names of Krishna. That's why you will be Namacharya. Completely opposite, birth and the position. Right? So why Mahaprabhu did that? Because Mahaprabhu wanted to establish that holy name in Kali Yuga is beyond everything. Holy name can transform everyone and anyone. And by establishing Haridas Thakur as the Namacharya, who took birth in a low-class family, he became the topmost person in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. So Mahaprabhu wanted to exhibit that personally through his pastimes. That birth is important to some extent, but in order to become a pure devotee of the Lord, birth is not a criteria. So chant the holy name of the Lord purely, it does not depend on what kind of birth you have. And that is special in Kali Yuga. And Mahaprabhu wanted to establish that very strongly. And he personally exhibited by establishing Haridas Thakur as the Namacharya. And Haridas Thakur, he came also early. He also has his own reason. Why is that? Because he knew that Mahaprabhu will perform his pastime only for 48 years. And he doesn't want to see the disappearance pastime of Lord Chaitanya. So he wanted to go before Mahaprabhu. That's why he came very early. So that he can go before Mahaprabhu. So in that way our acharyas are explaining many different ways. Why Haridas Thakur appeared so early, why he took birth in a non-Hindu family. So in this way, the glories of the holy name have been established in Kali Yuga. So Haridas Thakur life, there are so many aspects to learn. But we'll try to narrate some pastimes and get some important lessons in our life, and also at the end we'll have the disappearance first time, because today is the disappearance day of Haridas Thakur. So Haridas Thakur, when there was a pastime Mahaprakash Leela, so Mahaprabhu was talking to Haridas. Haridas, you remember when you are beaten up in 22 marketplaces. So that time, because it happened before, no? So you are beaten up in 22 marketplaces by Kazi's men. So I sent Sudarshan Chakra to kill all these people. But Sudarshan Chakra came back. And Mahaprabhu said that I was asking Sudarshan that I sent you to kill all these Yavanas, all these people of Kazi. But why did you come back? Why you did not follow my order? I am the Lord, you have to follow my order. He said, my dear Lord, I sincerely followed your order. He said, how come? I told you to kill them, you came back without killing them. How did you follow my order? Then Sudarshan said that, my dear Lord, you only declared that your devotees are greater than you. Right? Mahaprabhu said, yes. So my devotees are greater than me. So you ordered me to kill them, but your great devotee Haridas is telling to forgive them, not to kill them. To whom I should follow? I followed Haridas Thakur. Because according to your principle, your devotee is greater than you. So I have to follow Haridas Thakur order. Then I came back. Then Mahaprabhu said that Sudarshan failed. So what can I do? I have no other help. I have to go personally. So Mahaprabhu said, I went personally. And on your back, I put my back. And took all this beating. Do you believe, Haridas? And Mahaprabhu took out his chadar from the back and there was a red mark on the back of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And as soon as Haridas Thakur saw that, he fainted on the ground. That is Mahaprabhu's protection. Avasya Rakhivya Krishna Vishwasa Palana. You should not think it happened in other yugas. It happened in Kali Yuga also. Principle remains the same. Then you may say, oh, very good. Mahaprabhu protects, but Mahaprabhu protects who? Who is completely surrendered. Saranga saranagati hoibe jahar, tahar parthana sunesi Nanda Kumar. Who is completely surrendered at the lotus feet of Krishna, he will hear our prayer. Otherwise, it will not be audible. It will not be audible. We may loudly do chant so many things, but it will not be audible. Right? So why Haridas Thakur was protected by Lord Chaitanya personally? What is his qualification? Because Haridas Thakur took complete shelter of the holy name. Complete shelter. How? That is the first time. So Haridas Thakur was a completely absorbed, always from his birth, in chanting of the holy name. And he was completely effulgent. There is no mention he was initiated by some guru, he was initiated by somebody getting the mercy of some Vaishnavas. It's not like that. There is no mention of that. Naturally, because he's a Namacharya, he is endowed with that quality to chant the holy name purely. And because of that, he was completely effulgent from his childhood. Highly effulgent. So Hindus used to think, how come he is born in a Muslim family? How is he so effulgent? The Brahmanas were thinking, how he cannot be a Muslim. He cannot be a that kind of person. He must be a elevated person. So effulgent he is. And the Muslim used to think, who is he? So both parties are confused about Haridas Thakur. But Haridas Thakur, because of his purity, he became very popular. Because not only he, by his association, the Brahmanas become pure, the Muslims become pure, they are all becoming Vaishnavas. And used to chant the holy name. So alarm to the magistrate, Kazi, was worried that Haridas is spoiling our people. He should be punished. So he went to Navabhushansa. And Navabhushansa called Haridas. He said, you should chant the name of our religion. Why are you chanting other names? He said, whatever heart inspires, that should be chanted. So you are inspired to chant that name, you chant that name. I am inspired to chant the holy name of the Lord, Hare Krishna. What is the problem with that? So the way Haridas Thakur spoke and his purity convinced Navabhushensa also. He said, yes. Navabhushensa said, what Haridas said is making a lot of sense. But it made a lot of sense to Navabhushensa, but Kazi was not happy. He said, he may be right, but he is making other people bad. He is spoiling other people. He may be very good, his logic may be very good, but he is spoiling other people. So he should be punished. What is the punishment? Punishment is that he should be beaten up by whips. And it should be beaten up. He should be beaten up in 22 marketplaces. That was the standard. And according to the record of this punishment, the people, those who were beaten up in the past, they were beaten up only one or maximum two. After that, they will be dead or they will be surrendered. They cannot go beyond two marketplaces. By that you can understand what kind of beating. You should not underestimate. Just like we underestimate the sinful activities of Jagaya Mata, we laugh. But they are great mafias. In the same way, you should not underestimate this beating, the way he was beaten up. So he was beaten up in 22 marketplaces, Haridas Thakur. But while he was beaten up like that, what was the reaction of Haridas Thakur? And before he was beaten up, so Kazi said that you'll be forgiven. Don't worry about that. Only condition is that you have to give up chanting. If you stop chanting, all your offenses will be forgiven. So Haridas Thakur said, I cannot give up chanting. What to talk about giving up chanting? I cannot stay a moment without chanting the holy name of Lord. What to talk about giving up the chanting of the holy name? He said, if you don't give up the holy name, then you have to give up your body. Then what was the response of Haridas Thakur? Khanda khanda hai deho jai jodi pran, tobuna badane charibo harinam. He said, even my body is cut into pieces, each piece of my body will chant the holy name of the Lord. That was the qualification. And for us, if some problem, what happens? That will be also in his disappearance pastime also, we'll see his level of commitment to the holy name. So here also you are saying that he is facing death threat, not from ordinary person. The king of that place, he is getting death sentence. But what is his response? He doesn't want to give up. That is the quality of surrender. Those who are surrendered, they always feel the protection of the Lord. And you may think, oh, that happened during Mahaprabhu's time. Prabhu, now it happens. Always have a doubt. It happened in Satya Yuga, okay. It happened in Dapur Yuga, it was okay. It happened in Treta Yuga, is okay. It happened in Kali Yuga, Mahaprabhu's time, special time, maybe okay. But it also happens now. Yes, Prabhupada's time is also happened. So Prabhupada's disciples, they are chanting the holy name on the street. It was illegal. They are imprisoned. They are imprisoned. They are in the jail. And some other devotees wrote letter to Prabhupada that they are in jail and in order to get bail, you have to pay thousands of dollars. Prabhupada said, what the use of spending so much money? Better stay in the jail. So I used to think, my God, what kind of spiritual master is this? He's telling, okay, stay in the jail. But Haridas Thakur also was telling the same thing. Haridas Thakur was also imprisoned. And while he was coming out of the jail, and while talking to the prisoner, he's telling, you're very fortunate. See, what kind of blessing. Haridas Thakur is telling the prisoners that you're the most fortunate people in the planet. All the people are imprisoned in this world. But they are thinking they are free. But at least you are recognizing that you are imprisoned. That is the mercy of the Lord. So every situation of a devotee's life is favorable for Krishna consciousness. But who can understand that? Only fully surrendered souls. So Haridas Thakur said, okay, I bless you, stay here only. Haridas Thakur blessed them and gave the holy name. Don't try to imitate, but I'm telling the position of Haridas Thakur. And same thing, Prabhupada said, stay in jail. And whatever you are doing outside of the jail, do the same thing inside the jail. Guru Mukha Padma Vakya. Ahaituki Apratiyata Bhakti. So they started in the jail. Nam Sankirtan, classes, all started. And the prisoners started becoming devotees. And the jail super started thinking, oh my God, I thought danger has been reduced by bringing them inside the jail, but then danger has increased. And he called all of them. He said, you are more dangerous inside, so better go outside. So they got bail and went outside. It's a real life story. That is of the holy name. And same thing happened about Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita in America. So America, there is a case in the Supreme Court of New York that this movement is a brainwashing movement, is a threat to Americans. And this religion should be banned. The message of Bhagavad Gita, message of Bhagavatam should be banned. Legal case. So then whole existence of ISKCON is challenged. Bhagavad Gita is our foundation. They are telling it's a brainwashing material. So what to do? Prabhupada used to say, yes, we are doing brainwashing. Why? There are so many dirts in the brain that needs to be washed. Prabhupada used to say like that. But case happened in the Supreme Court. What to do? People are in anxiety. Prabhupada said, why you are in anxiety? Our fight will be the verses of Bhagavad Gita, verses of Srimad Bhagavatam. You carry Srimad Bhagavatam with you when the court hearing will start. As soon as the judge will ask question, you start your answer from the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. First question, first verse. Second question, second verse. Continue. So turn the courtroom into Bhagavatam class. Prabhupada always liked good fight. He was a fighter. That's why he's Senapati Bhakta. He's not a coward person, just go, oh, fight, who? Scared. No. He loves fight for establishing Krishna consciousness. He is not scared. I cannot say so many other things. He has said so many things to his disciples. He was a fighter. So, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya again. So they entered in the courtroom. The hearing started first day. First verse, long purport. First day hearing over. Second day, second verse. Continued. Then judge said, how many verses are like that? He said, we have only 18,000. So we can manage, no problem. So judge started thinking, my God. And Prabhupada also said, let this case continue for years. So judge started thinking, I have to do something. Then he called his friend. He's a PhD in the philosophy of India. He started thinking that this Bhaktivedanta Swami, his books are really good books, or what's your opinion? He said, his books are the basis of religious principles, very authentic, and it can change America in a very nice way. So he heard it. And next day, hearing is over, today is a judgment. So he declared that Hare Krishna movement is a bona fide religion coming from India. So Hare Krishna movement has been legalized in the Supreme Court of New York City. That's called fighter. Why? Because he has complete faith in Krishna. So Haridas Thakur was not worried. Oh, I'll be beaten up, I'll be killed, no problem. Khanda khanda hai deho jai jodi pranta buna badan chari bhori. I'll continue chanting. So when he was beaten up in 22 marketplaces, Haridas Thakur was smiling. See, the level. Because he is the incarnation of Prahlad Maharaj, no? Same example. Why Prahlad Maharaj and Brahma together? That is also explained by our acharyas. Everything our acharyas are meticulous in explaining. So Brahma means the source of all knowledge, no? He is the most intelligent person. But people think, who chants Hare Krishna? Who is sentimental person? Those who are sentimental, they chant Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Mahaprabhu was also criticized. After taking sannyas, from Kesava Bharati, all his god brothers, they are criticizing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu like anything, that your main focus should be studying Vedanta, but you are chanting the holy name only, like a sentimental person. You are not chanting, you are singing loudly and you are dancing on the street. What kind of sannyasi are you? And there is a meeting between him and Prakashananda Saraswati in Varanasi. And there is a discussion. Then Mahaprabhu took a very humble stand to tell the big stories in a small way. And Mahaprabhu said, what can I do? He asked the same question. Why you don't associate with us? You don't spend time with us? We are all our same family members. But you only chant and dance like a sentimental person. Why? He said, what can I do? My guru told me that you are a number one fool. Murkho tumi. Vedanta adhyayane nai adhikar. You don't have no eligibility to study Vedanta. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is instructed by his guru that you are a number one fool and you don't have any right or authority to study Vedanta. So what can I do? And he not only did that, he gave one mantra to me. I don't know what kind of mantra he gave. Kiva mantra dilagosai kiva tar bol, jopite jopite mantra korila pagal. He said, I don't know my guru gave what kind of mantra. As soon as I chant this mantra, I become mad. So madman, what he does, how we can understand? So please don't blame me, because as soon as I chant, I act like a madman, because I become mad. So in that way, he started establishing the glories of the holy name. And the way he meticulously explained, you can read from Chaitanya Charitamrita, high philosophical discussion. Then Prakashananda Saraswati Thakur, Prakashananda Saraswati became convinced, and all the sannyasis of Varanasi became Gauriya Vaishnavas. That is the potency of the holy name. So coming back to the point of taking shelter of the holy name, that Haridas Thakur was smiling and chanting. And he took the incarnation of Brahma to tell to the whole world that the most intelligent people of this age of Kali will chant the holy name. Krishna varnam tisha krishnam sanga pangasto parsadam jaggai sankirtane pray jajantihi sumedasa. Those who are most intelligent, they will take shelter of the holy name of the Lord. The symptom of intelligence in the age of Kali is taking shelter of the holy name. That's why Haridas Thakur, he took the incarnation of Brahma. And why he also took incarnation of Prahlad Maharaj? Because Prahlad Maharaj is the most compassionate person. So most intelligent and most compassionate. It's a totally unique combination. Generally, those who are intelligent people, they don't become compassionate. They become self-centered, intellectual scholars. So it's a combination. So what is the climax of intellect? What is the climax of scholarship? Taking shelter of the holy name. That is the perfection of scholarship. And what is the outcome of that scholarship culmination? To share that holy name to the whole world. Compassion. If these combinations are there, that is the qualification of a Gauriya Vaishnava. So Gauriya Vaishnava means he is the most intelligent person and who chants the holy name, and he shares that holy name out of compassion to the whole world. That is the symptom of a Gauriya Vaishnava. So Haridas Thakur is the embodiment of that principle. Embodiment of that quality. That's why both Brahma and Prahlad came together as Haridas Thakur. So he was smiling and chanting the holy name while he was beaten up in 22 marketplaces. And Jiva Goswami explains, if someone can meditate on this pastime of Haridas Thakur is beaten up in 22 marketplaces and chanting the holy name of the Lord, he will never experience any pain in this world. That is the benediction of Jiva Goswami. So such a powerful pastime. So he was chanting, smiling, but these people were tired. How long they can beat? They were very tired and they pleaded that Haridas Thakur, please die. If you don't die, then we have to die, because the Qazi said, if you cannot kill, then you will be killed. So Haridas Thakur became very compassionate. Okay, I'll die. So he entered into Samadhi, transcendental Samadhi, as if dead. So what to do now with his dead body? Although he is not dead, he is transcendentally in Samadhi. What to do? So Qazi said, somebody said that he should be buried inside. He said, no, he is not a Muslim. He cannot be buried. He should be burned? No. He should be thrown into the Ganges water? No. Nothing is allowed. Somehow by Mahaprabhu's arrangement, Mahaprabhu came and entered into his body, and the body became so heavy, they could not do anything with that body, and they kept that body at the bank of the Ganges, and Ganga Devi took him into her water, because Ganga Devi wanted to get association of Haridas Thakur to become purified. So we go to Ganges to purify ourselves, but Ganga Devi wants to purify by the association of Haridas Thakur. That is the level of Haridas Thakur. So Haridas Thakur entered into the water of the Ganges, then he came out in the Fulia village and started chanting the holy name. And when news spread, the Qazi's people said, he is not an ordinary man. He must be a big peer. And Brahmanas, they were surprised what a personality is, but they had a doubt. Knowledge means, too much knowledge without proper understanding means doubt. So they had a doubt. What is the doubt? Haridas Thakur, they started asking questions, Haridas Thakur, very deep answer Haridas Thakur will give to this question. So they said that you are Namacharya. You have taken complete shelter of the holy name. You are Mahabhagavat, pure devotee of the Lord. Karma does not act on you. They know all the Shastric injunctions. Then why you have to be beaten up in 22 marketplaces like this, tortured like this? What is the explanation? So what is the explanation given by Haridas Thakur? He should say, oh, they made an offense to me, they will suffer. They offensed at the lotus feet of the Vaishnavas, a pure devotee will create only disturbance. He never thought like that. Because when he was requesting Mahaprabhu that he should die before him, that time he said, I am not a devotee. He said, I am Bhakta Bhas. I am an imitating devotee. Haridas Thakur. I am not a devotee. But still you are merciful. You should give mercy on him. We will discuss that. So, why you suffered? He said that I committed an offense. What offense I committed? I heard the blasphemy of the holy name, and I also heard the blasphemy of the Vaishnavas. And because of that offense, I am suffering. By this, Haridas Thakur is conveying a deep message for all the sadhakas. If you chant the holy name, but if you hear the offensive statements about the holy name, and if you hear Vaishnava Parad, not only doing of Vaishnava Parad, I only heard. If you hear also, that will be the consequence. So by that we can be so cautious. We have to be so cautious. That I chant the holy name, but left and right, middle, center, everywhere, talk bad about devotees, then what will be the consequences? Haridas Thakur is telling, I just heard Vaishnava Parad. That's why I'm suffering like this. So what will happen to those sadhakas, those who are committing Vaishnava Parad? It's a very grave message Haridas Thakur is giving to all of us. We should not hear also. And it is also injunction of the Shastra. As soon as you hear, if you are a Kshatriya, he should be finished. Or his tongue should be cut. And if you are a Brahmana, then you should defeat him by discussion, argument. And if you cannot do all these things, in Kali Yuga it is recommended not to do both these things. It is recommended to leave that place. That is the recommendation of the Shastra. And if you don't leave that place, reaction will come. So by this we should understand that holy name is very powerful, but his potency will manifest if we follow this principle. Otherwise, he will be acting in a powerful way, in a different manner. We will suffer. So now time is very limited, so I have to go to other aspect of Haridas Thakur. The purity, he took shelter. This is one example. Another example is that while he became popular, the Ramchandra Khan, right? He became very envious. That is the nature of this world. If someone becomes famous, people will become enemies. And Prabhupada used to say, if there are enemies, it means you are doing something. If there is no enemy, means you are a useless guy. Nothing you are doing in life. Prabhupada personally told that. You should be very happy. If there is some opposition, means you are doing something. If there is no opposition, means you are good for nothing. That is the mood. So, Haridas Thakur was chanting the holy name only. He was not doing any management or something like that. People think that if you manage, then you create enemies. No. Wherever you are, if you become popular, there will be enemies. Some people have illusion that if you are in management, then you will create enemy. No. In this world, whatever you do, if you do Charanamrita very nicely also, people will be envious. So he is doing so nice service. Like that. This world is like that. If you do something good, there will be opposition. So Haridas Thakur was just simply chanting. He does not bother anyone. He stays with him. He just chants the holy name. But he becomes popular because purity is the force. If someone does something, he will be popular. You don't have to try. But some people want to become popular. That is another problem. That is Kali Yuga symptom. They want to become popular. Popular speaker, popular kathakar, popular singer, popular manager, popular leader, popular, so many things they want to become. They have more problem. Right? Because that's a spiritual problem. Problem will come from within. But if you don't do with the intention to become popular, you become popular. Because Madhavendra Puri, he was trying to escape popularity, but popularity was following him. That is the nature of pure devotional service. When you become pure, you will become popular. So Haridas Thakur became very popular, the envious Ramchandra Khan want to defame him. That is the way the envious people want to attack. Defamation is worse than death. So defame him. So for a sadhu, the character assassination is the best way to defame. So he arranged a wonderful, beautiful prostitute. She was arranged to go to seduce Haridas Thakur. And that prostitute was very confident, very beautiful looking. She said, I'll just take care of him in 3 days. 3 nights is enough. I don't need more than that. Because she did not know to whom she is trying to play the game. So first day, she came and she started seducing him. So Haridas Thakur said, okay, I'll fulfill your desire. So wonderful, Haridas Thakur's response. He's not telling that. Very nicely. So you came for your desire, I'll fulfill your desire. But I have taken a vow. I have taken a vow to chant 10 million names. So I have to finish that. So it will be finished hopefully tonight. Just sit down as soon as I finish my chanting, I'll satisfy your desire. So morning, till morning, chanting was not finished. So morning appeared. So he said, Haridas Thakur, beg forgiveness. I am sorry. I could not satisfy you tonight. Definitely I'll satisfy you next night. So she came back. So informed Ramchandra Khan that I could not do it, but tonight I'll manage. So second night also went in that way. Whole night chanting did not finish. He said, I'm really sorry. Extremely I'm sorry. I know the chanting is so intense that so he said, ak koti naam means 10 million names I have to chant. Definitely, hopefully, I'll finish next night. So, but what's happening now? She wanted to, she came to change Haridas Thakur. But by hearing his holy name, she started changing. That is the power of purity. So third night, she came and completely surrendered to Haridas Thakur. And Haridas Thakur told that, I knew that you will be sent by Ramchandra Khan. Pure devotee knows all the, what you can say, that conspiracy. You should not think, oh, they don't know, they are sadhus. They know everything. Sadhus knows, sadhu, just like Lord knows so many, Lord knows everything. By the mercy of the Lord, sadhus also know things. So Haridas Thakur said, I knew that you will be sent by Ramchandra Khan. But why I did not leave this place? I waited. I wanted to deliver you. See the compassion. This is the compassion of Prahlad Maharaj. The person who was used by the person who is conspiring to defame Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur is waiting for that conspiracy to deliver that person. See the potency of purity. So Haridas Thakur initiated her. And she renounced everything and she became also Vaishnavi, pure Vaishnavi. She said, Haridas Thakur instructed him, chant the holy name and worship Tulsi Devi. Your life will become perfect. So in that way, he left that place. Then, so it is explained that Haridas Thakur's disappearance is at the same level of Bhishma's disappearance. So we already explained that Haridas Thakur wanted to leave before Mahaprabhu's disappearance. So one generally Mahaprabhu used to go every day after Jagannath Darshan, used to go to Siddha Bakul, used to meet Haridas Thakur, used to give prasad and used to go back. That is daily routine. And Govinda used to come to give prasad also to Haridas Thakur. So one day Govinda came and he saw that Haridas Thakur is lying down and he came with prasad. He said that I cannot take prasad. He said, why? He said that I did not finish my chanting yet. So how can I take prasad? But at the same time you have brought prasad, how can I dishonor it? So he took little prasad and then continued his chanting. So Govinda came back and informed Mahaprabhu about the health condition of Haridas Thakur. So Mahaprabhu came. Then Mahaprabhu asked Haridas, how are you? He said, my body is okay, but my mind is not okay. Why your mind is not okay? Why you are telling like that? Because I am not able to chant the holy name. I am not able to finish my daily quota. That is my health issue. So by this, Mahaprabhu is conveying that even at the Siddha level, sadhana has to be continued. And Prabhupada in the purport is writing that Raghunathas Goswami, that he never gave up his sadhana routine. Very strictly out of the Sis Goswami is talking about Raghunathas Goswami is the embodiment of sadhana. He was very particular about sadhana. He used to chant minimum 64 rounds. He used to do Govardhan Parikrama. He used to narrate the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for at least 3 hours in the afternoon. And he used to offer obeisances to the Vaishnavas 2,000 times every day. He used to offer obeisances to his Ishtadev 1,500 times every day. Very particular. Not a single day was without this. Very strict in sadhana. Same way Haridas Thakur also. He is extremely sick now. Body is collapsing. But he is telling, my body is okay. But my mind is not okay. That is the level of Haridas Thakur. And Haridas Thakur said, my dear Lord, and before telling that, he said, Haridas, you have already achieved perfection. You are a Siddha. Why you are chanting so many rounds? And we pray, when Lord will tell us. But Haridas was instructed like that. You don't have to chant the holy name. You already achieved perfection. Then Haridas said, my dear Lord, I am realizing, I am feeling, I am seeing that very soon you will wind up your pastime. And I don't want to be part of that. So I have a desire. My desire is that I want to leave my body. Please give me blessings. And Mahaprabhu said, how, whatever I am is because of you, Haridas. And if you leave me, then what will happen to me? Then Haridas, out of humility, is telling that I am like an insect. He's telling, I'm like insect. If a ant dies in this world, is there any difference in the world? So my death is like that. You have so many millions of devotees. If I leave, what's the difference? And Amacharya, the eternal associate of Lord Chaitanya, incarnation of Brahma, Prahlad, he is telling that he is like a insect. His death is like the death of an ant. That is the qualification. That's why he is Namacharya. Trinadapi sunichena, tararapi sahishnuna, amanina manadena, kirtaniya sadahari. You don't have to read this verse. You just read the pastimes of Haridas Thakur, all are revealed. He is the embodiment of this verse. That's why you have to take shelter of Haridas Thakur, because that is the hope of our life. So then Mahaprabhu said that you desire, so definitely Krishna will fulfill your desire. By this, another deep message. Mahaprabhu did not want that Haridas should live, but Haridas wants to live. So by this, Mahaprabhu is trying to establish that pure devotee's desire is greater than the desire of Krishna. Even if Krishna doesn't want to give mercy to someone, but if a pure devotee wants, Krishna is bound by that. So pure devotee's desire is the only hope in our life. Because we are not qualified to get the mercy of the Lord. We are completely unqualified. But the compassion of the pure devotee, that is the only hope we have. So here, the same principle is established. So Haridas Thakur, he desired to live before Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu said, Krishna will fulfill your desire. So Mahaprabhu left, and next day Mahaprabhu came, and he started Harinam Sankirtan. He came with all the associates. All the associates. Mahaprabhu started Harinam Sankirtan. And Vakrashar Pandit, all other associates, chanting, dancing. It's like a festival, disappearance festival. Then it was going on and on. than Haridas Thakur. Many devotees were glorifying Haridas Thakur. Mahaprabhu was glorifying Haridas Thakur. So then Haridas Thakur told Mahaprabhu, because Haridas said to Mahaprabhu that I want to leave my body, I have some condition. How I want to leave? I want to put your lotus feet on my heart. And I want to see your wonderful face with my eyes. And I want to chant your name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, from my tongue. And with that, I want to leave my body. So by this, Haridas Thakur is teaching us how to leave our body. So as per that request, so Haridas Thakur told Mahaprabhu, please sit down. Sit in front of me. Then what he did? He started gazing at the lotus face of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He took his lotus feet on his heart and from his mouth he started chanting, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. And with that chanting of the mantra, he left his body. Then what happened? Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took Haridas Thakur's body on his lap and started again dancing. The way it is explained by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Mahaprabhu was mad in dancing. Time was going. Mahaprabhu was not aware what's going on. Then Swarup Damodar, the secretary, he said, Mahaprabhu, we have to do the final rituals of Haridas' body. Please stop. Then his body was taken to the ocean and his body was washed, bathed, and Mahaprabhu declared, from this day, the ocean has become Mahatirtha by the touch of Haridas Thakur's body. So then he was brought, then his samadhi was prepared, and then Mahaprabhu personally went to Jagannath temple area and started begging for prasad, for the disappearance feast of Haridas Thakur. And Swarup Damodar stopped him. He said, you don't have to do. They are feeling, Mahaprabhu is begging door to door. Then he was brought back. Then there was a feast prasad. Mahaprabhu was serving personally. He was not eating. But no devotee was eating because Mahaprabhu was not eating. Then Mahaprabhu started taking prasad. Then after prasadam was over, then Mahaprabhu personally put chandan garland to all the devotees. And after that, he declared, he gave a benediction. Whoever participated in the disappearance festival of Haridas Thakur, in the form of singing, in the form of dancing, in the form of putting sand in the samadhi, in the form of taking prasad, in whatever way, if anybody takes part in the disappearance festival of Haridas Thakur, he'll definitely get Krishna. That is the guarantee Mahaprabhu has given. So that is the potency of Haridas Thakur's disappearance. And just like Krishna's appearance and disappearance is transcendental, his pure devotees' appearance and disappearance is also transcendental. So Haridas Thakur went back to the place of Mahaprabhu's pastime and continuing his service to Mahaprabhu. So we beg at the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur, we beg at the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so that we can have a little taste in chanting of the holy name. It is said also that if we take part in this discussion one day, definitely from our tongue, Shuddha Naam will manifest. And that is the hope, that by the mercy of Haridas Thakur, one day we can chant the holy name purely and attain the lotus feet of Krishna and perfect our life. With that hope and prayer, we will conclude our discussion today. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। नमाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की, हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, श्रीमन महाप्रभु की, नितायगौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल।